Hello and happy new year to all of you today. I was doing my, well, earlier today, which was last year, I was doing my end of month and end of year giveaway stream over on Twitch when I started to hear about a whole lot of new stuff that was being revealed by LEGO, or people were finding official pictures from official sources of new sets that are coming out in March. So we've got all the January 1 stuff that's actually on the market and available now, but got some new things to look at here, starting in this video with creator stuff and creator animals. So we've got adorable dogs here. Now what I'm gonna do is actually take you over to the source of this, which is the Australian market, Australian region catalog, online catalog. And watch this. They've actually got this little thing in here, which is cool. They've got the 3D 360 spin on it. It's a render, but it lets you see, you know, pretty clearly what you actually get, including the leash here, the brush, the ball, bowl, and a toy for the dogs to play with. Well, a couple of toys for the dogs to play with. I appreciate the fully comic style here. There's a little print there as well. Fully comic style, you know, cartoonish, whimsical, silly, funny. I think that's a very important thing for them to preserve. You know, it is fundamentally a toy company. They make things that are intended to bring smiles to people of, well, mostly first and foremost kids, but also people of all ages, right? 7+. They don't say 7 to 99 anymore, anything like that. Not everything needs to be 100% realistic. And I appreciate the commitment to that here, including with all of the curls shown for a little toy poodle over here. You know, having exposed studs as well as even exposed hollow and open studs. It's a 3-in-1 set. You turn these three dogs into these dogs instead, only two at a time. So, with the parts from three, you can make these two, or you can make these two, and then you'll have a bunch left over as well. So it looks like you got a Frenchie and a Yorkie, is it? I don't know what this is, and is that some kind of dachshund, but not sure exactly. A beagle over here, toy poodle, that's a retriever, a golden? There's a yellow lab. That's probably trying to be a golden. It's not perfect, but anyway, adorable little set. I like this one. I'm definitely going to get this one. I don't know if I'm going to have time to prioritize getting this in there with all of the other sets that I'm going to be covering over the coming months. I also have to keep doing some work on the city as well, but this interests me personally. This one does go more into the realistic style. I like the colors and I like the source material. It's a 3-in-1 set that also allows you to create a nice underwater scene, not just a fish, but a full underwater scene in the sea with a little bit of coral. Or you can make this tree frog here that is oversized. Another whimsical release over here is the Magical Unicorn. 7+ set, it's a 3-in-1. It's small, but it's 3-in-1 that lets you make a bird or a magical rainbow colored seahorse. I like the seahorse most out of these three here personally, but wait, there's more. For folks who like the minifig, oh no, what, oh, there we go. For folks who like minifig scaled stuff, check this out. Yeah, there we go. Cozy house. Cozy house. That looks pretty darn good. Now watch this. Once again, they've got one of those 360 spins. Very nice, look at that, which means I can stop it. You see some bowls here, the bedroom there, which has, it's intended to have space for two. You can probably have two people on it with them hanging off the edges a little bit. That's good use of space. This reminds me of like the best of small cozy size of 1980s to early 70s. Yeah, so 1980s to early 90s Lego houses with late aughts, late 2000, early 2010 era creator stuff. Or even City, I think City did some houses. It just combines a number of things that I like that I'm seeing here. Nice little builds. I hope that they continue to do more things like this. This is almost perfect to me. Compact little just house for minifigs. I think that's great. Now, what else can you turn that into though? Over here you can zoom in a bit, but it's not working that well, so let me go to the, sorry, that's not right, this way. The PDF version, it's not great. quality. Zooming in over here because it's got a lot of compression on it, but you can make a seaside little condo unit that's tall, three stories high. Or you can make this A-frame shaped thing, a lake house. That's what that is, it's a lake house, which is a little bit of a call over to the Ideas A-frame house that's coming out later this year as well. And then we get a couple more small sets down here. Space Shuttle, tiny little Space Shuttle, 3-in-1, lets you turn it into an astronaut or a Vic Viper. I am so thankful that somebody at LEGO loves Gladius, because we've gotten so many Vic Viper inspired designs, which is fantastic. And then this is a chopper, the vintage motorcycle, which can be turned into a, I forget the term for that style. And then this is like a dragster. That's not a good alternate build. That one's fine. The main build here is strong. Keep in mind, this is very small. Look at the pieces. This is very, very small. We don't have prices for these. We don't have exact part counts for at least most of them. And maybe one of these had a part count listed for it. No, maybe not. I haven't seen them myself, but we'll be getting more information about these. Again, I'm probably not going to buy this myself. This I'm highly interested in. This one is lower priority, but I like it. I kind of want to cover that if I can find time for it. This I'm absolutely going to do 100%. This is a maybe. This is a stronger maybe. It's probably going to, hopefully it's going to be a $10 set in the United States, and I just really want to give a lot of play, pun semi-intended, to the $10 price range, because I think it's really, really strong and something that needs to be focused on a lot, and not just the $300, $400, $500, $600, $800 sets for rich, hyper-rich adult collectors. So yeah, we'll see about those. Whichever ones that I get, I will either be building live here in live streams or over on my Twitch channel, and then I will publish the reviews over on my LEGO Reviews channel, which is not this channel here, but the LEGO Reviews channel. It's been going for quite some time. Links in the video description and on my main channel page and all of that. Thank you very much for watching. Again, Happy New Year, and I'll talk to you again soon. Bye for now.